Continuous Monitoring Automated Blood Culture Systems. Introduction. Blood culture is considered to be the gold standard investigation for detection of septicemia. The automated blood culture instruments are designed for the rapid and standardized detection of microorganisms in blood and sterile body fluids. With changes in healthcare financing and emphasis on quality, continuous monitoring blood culture systems are increasingly being adopted and utilized in microbiology laboratories. The introduction of commercial, fully automated, continuous monitoring blood culture systems has led to earlier detection and better identification of pathogens. Types. Three of such systems are currently available. The BacTec, the VersaTrek, the Bacti Alert. Different labs can use different automated blood culture systems. It is important to understand the use and maintenance of your system with the help of technical support. The user manual should always be kept handy and understood thoroughly by all staff who handle the instrument. For details on maintenance of all automated blood culture systems, please refer to the training module on equipment management. We will use Bacti Alert for blood cultures in this demonstration. Bacti Alert Culture Platform. Components. The key components of an automated blood culture system are basic unit housing onboard incubation of culture vials, bottles, measurement, detector system, hardware and software for converting electrical results into textual printout. Data management system. Blood culture vials. Vials are available for adults, pediatric patients, mycobacterium tuberculosis, etc. Quality control kits, computer supplies. Principle. The Bacti Alert culture system works on calorimetric technology for detection of microorganisms. A carbon dioxide sensor is bonded to the bottom of each bottle and is separated from the broth medium by a semi-permeable membrane. The sensor is impregnated with water vapor when the bottles are autoclaved during the manufacturing process. The membrane is impermeable to most ions, including hydrogen ions, and to components of media as well as degraded blood. It is nearly impermeable to water, but is freely permeable to carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide produced by growing organisms diffuses across the membrane into the sensor and dissolves in the water, thereby generating hydrogen ions according to the following equation. Free hydrogen ions can interact with the sensor, which is blue to dark green in the alkaline state. As carbon dioxide is produced and dissolves in the water, the concentration of hydrogen ions increases and the pH decreases. This causes the sensor to become lighter green and eventually yellow, which results in an increase of red light reflected by the sensor. Different vials, media, and different instrument models are available according to use of lab. Procedure. Lab personnel must strictly follow standard work precautions when handling blood during the entire process of performing blood culture. Load bottles. Touch load bottle icon. Read the barcode of the bottle meant for loading. Type in the patient identification, sex, age, type of specimen, etc. as is required. Open any of the drawers with green lights flashing. Load the bottle randomly in any of the cell with green flashing light. Close the drawer and touch the tick mark on the monitor. Unload bottles. Touch the unload bottle icon, whichever is highlighted. The cells which contain bottles to be unloaded will be flashing green light. Unload the bottle and close the drawer. Growth of bacteria in the specimen causes the sensor to become lighter green and eventually yellow, which results in an increase of red light reflected by the sensor and is detected by the photodetector system. All the vials have to be autoclaved before disposal as per general hospital guidelines. Advantages of a continuous monitoring automated blood culture system over manual blood culture methods. Higher sensitivity for organism recovery. Faster time to positivity, or TTP, that is the time from incubation till the detection of the first positive signal. Fully automated and computerized. Easy loading and unloading of bottles. Expandable to accommodate larger or smaller volumes. Disadvantages. High implementation cost. Equipment must be maintained. Need of continuous power supply. Precautions to be taken with continuous monitoring automated blood culture systems. The continuous monitoring automated blood culture systems are closed systems. That is, they minimize contamination by minimal handling of the blood. Therefore, it is important that the blood is collected and transferred to the culture bottle with utmost care and precautions. Also, the test is expensive when compared to the manual methods. Hence, it is in best interest of the patient as well as the laboratory to collect and handle the blood specimens with care. Determine first the site of blood collection, the number and volume of samples that need to be collected. Take all aseptic precautions while collecting the sample. Avoid drawing blood through indwelling intravascular catheters unless blood cannot be obtained by venipuncture. Blood collected from intravascular catheters may carry a risk of contamination. Transfer the collected blood into the culture bottles as per the manufacturer's instructions. Always refer to the operator's manual while handling the culture bottles or the automated system. Each vial should be labeled with the appropriate patient information. Each request slip should also have all the patient information. The inoculated bottles should be transported as quickly as possible to the laboratory. When this is not possible, store the bottles according to the manufacturer's instructions till the bottles can be transported to the laboratory. Maintenance. Maintenance and calibration of the automated blood culture platforms is strictly as per the manufacturer's instructions or operator manuals that are provided at the time of installation. Most of these systems require little maintenance from the user to provide reliable performance. All these instruments continuously work, require an outside environmental temperature of 25 degrees centigrade and continuous UPS power supply. Apart from this, preventive maintenance is done by company service engineer biannually or annually. Daily or weekly maintenance. On daily basis, it is required to print quality control report from instrument and on weekly basis, air filters need to be cleaned. Calibration and quality control. Manufacturer will provide a service representative to perform initial installation and calibration of the instrument. Instruments are either auto-calibrated or require minimal calibration by user. Use quality control performance vial or quality control kit to calibrate instrument detection systems as recommended by the manufacturer. For instrument with incubator modules, set desired temperature and allow to equilibrate for 24 hours before placing cultures into the incubator. Check temperature with the NBS calibrated thermometer. If temperature recorded by a calibrated thermometer differs by more than 0.5 degrees centigrade, recalibrate by following instructions in the operator manual. Limitations. Automated blood culture systems currently represent the gold standard for diagnosis of septicemia. Nonetheless, they have the following limitations. A very high volume of blood, about 10 to 30 milliliters per culture set, is needed in an adult. Positive results require hours to days of incubation. All potential bloodstream pathogens cannot be detected. Many technical factors can cause variability of the sensitivity of blood culture systems. The most important are probably the volume of blood cultured, the broth medium used for culture, and the initial colony-forming units of the microorganism in the blood. These instruments require continuous power supply and constant ambient room temperature. Failing to adhere to these requirements and good lab practices may result in false positivity and data loss.